Anger continues to build over the noise that will come with the new Sydney airport. Residents have taken to the streets to voice their concerns, and the United Nations is so worried about the Blue Mountains, it's demanding a full report.
Making some noise in the mountains today to fight the noise that's on its way from Western Sydney Airport and planned flight paths that'll put planes overhead.
So these flight paths are coming in lower. We've got no curfew, which means we will have freight planes flying over. My daughter lives at Lelyfield. I know what it's like under a flight path.
We live in a pretty quiet sort of suburban area and, you know, all of a sudden having, you know, planes over the top of you. No.
And over a World Heritage listed area.
5 million tourists a year, 78,000 residents living here, some of the most pristine wilderness in Australia. Wildlife will be affected. The noise from aeroplanes will change migration patterns.
The United Nations World Heritage Committee calling for a report on the airport's impact. Thousands already signing a petition.
Page after page, 125 pages.
Demanding a curfew and cap on flights like Sydney Airport.
The people of Sydney's West and the Blue Mountains are being treated like second-class citizens.
And they all vote.
Penrith's mayor concerned about how early daytime operations will begin and with the number of flights set to triple in 7 years.
It does not talk about both runways and the future use within that runway. How do we plan for the future when we don't actually understand what that's going to look like?
Community groups and local councils have made or are finalising their submissions. Wednesday is the deadline for the public to have its say. Paul Catterick, 7 News.